72 brand new 1 minute plays by 40 Bay Area playwrights, staged by an amazingly talented team of 7 Bay Area directors and performed by a company of 40 local actors. 1 minute Play Festival is we're a national organization based in New York. We go around the country and partner with playwright and community specific theaters, sourcing local talent. Investigating what is in the collective conscious. So the moments that you will see today, we did not tell the writers what to write about, but simply offered them a way to approach how to make a moment. We looked at sort of what is being said and how to kind of make the pieces speak to each other. To say to you guys, this is essentially what your artistic community is thinking about and responding to through a series of moments right here, right now. I would like to say hello to our viewers on New Play TV. We are live streaming on newplaytv.info, hashtag newplay, hashtag 1MPF. Hello.
Hi, I'm Randy Simak. I'm the managing producer of Playwrights Foundation, and we really appreciate you all being here today with us. You are supporting us by being in this room right now. and supporting the work that we do with new plays and playwrights. We've been doing it for over 35 years. We're a new play development lab. If you want to support us further, you can donate to us. We have a donate bucket on the concessions table and also info about how to give to us, and we would appreciate your support. We're in the middle of a fundraising campaign right now. We're trying to raise $20,000, and we're just a quarter of the way there, so any help that you can give on top of being here, we'd appreciate it. Another way that you can support us is that on most of your seats, there are clipboards with audience surveys. We would love to know who you are for our funders and how to stay in contact with you. Please fill them out. You can leave the clipboards underneath the chairs, and we'll pick up the pieces of paper at intermission and after the show. If there's a, in the case of emergency, we have emergency exits right here and in the back of the theater right this way. Dominic?
Well, it's, the other thing that's important to say is the money that you spend today on the tickets goes to producing the cost of the festival, but also the money that Playwrights Foundation raises from this will go to support programming for the playwrights at the Playwrights Foundation. So by you buying in and being with us here today, you're giving directly back to your community. So thank you for doing so, and thank you for being here to share with us. And with that being said, here's the San Francisco One Minute Play Festival. Enjoy.
Guys moved on after Google bought them out. I wish I held on to those stock options.
I don't know if I really want to antagonize Rachel.
I do sometimes get emails after 7 p.m.
I'm not all that crazy about oatmeal.
2013 sucks.
They say.
Peanut butter.
Was all you had.
They took my blood and told me to come out here and wait.
Again?
I'm supposed to argue with her and tell her to go faster or something?
So we just wait?
Till what?
Till they call me. Again.
And then?
Yeah.
It's been like an hour already.
You got someplace to be?
No.
You sure?
About what?
You need anything? You sure?
No. That's a stupid reason not to, right?
We already talked about it.
It's like all we have is peanut butter and like a half gallon of milk.
And classes and homework and...
Here, you have it. You're eating for two now.
Right now.
So when they call your name again, that's it? You just go and they...
Yeah.
You ready?
What kind of sandwich is that?
PB&J. My question is more relevant. Why did you rip the GPS out of the car?
Look at this. I mean, listen!
Place 9 in jelly jar now.
Do it!
Get jelly on knife and spread jelly on bread now.
Oh my god!
I know, right? And watch, it gives advice. I can press alternative routes and...
Leave stand immediately. You deserve better. You deserve someone who will whisper roomy poems to you at night. And he has been cheating on you with Bunny Hastings at 1:16. I'll get there. I am sorry.
Honey?
It's $800, it's just me!
It's both of us! It's that time! it just went off and sent him a text message.
Wunderbar! Tutelor! Mamma mia! Oh, baby!
In five languages!
What do you expect? It's Switzerland!
Coming, my lovelies!
You put your red Ferdinand
in your dreams, Bella.
He'll bring the machine.
Oh, the inseminator. Oh, no. It's so cold and I'm carrying that. I'm getting a headache.
The special tonight is fish, crisp, wild salmon, bonjour.
Yeah, the fish is a problem.
Why is the fish a problem?
Well, what do we really know about this fish?
The chef bought this salmon directly off the boat in Princeton Harbor at 6 o'clock this morning.
Delicious.
The fish comes with?
A dash of salt, and optional.
The salt comes from?
The Himalayan mountains. Hand-harvested pink sea salt.
Pepper?
I recommend the fish salmon, fresh pepper.
But I love fresh pepper.
She just wants to know where the fresh pepper's from.
It's locally sourced, the Castro.
You don't mean Safeway.
It was on sale. Cherry cherry pepper from the Malabar coast.
Corporate pepper is not local.
Honey, I brought the kid. Your peppercorns, pink, black, or white? Hot martini, very cold, very dry, shake and stir, whatever, from the first gin the bartender can reach as soon as possible. $3.
And for you, ma'am, to drink.
Let's discuss your selection of bottled water.
This is the place.
Better there. You lucky dog. Lucky dog. Yeah. This is the place.
This is the place.
Bills are being counted.
That's right. The dog must be pure black. Otherwise, it's no good.
Very filthy. The insides. The meat should be sweet. Like game. You know, like medicine.
Deer. Now that's a meat.
Cafe. Why am I even talking to you?
I used to work in a cafe.
I'm pulling in 2/3 what I used to make there, and I don't have to pay taxes, so I'm basically making the same as you.
No shit.
Flexible hours. You get to work outdoors. I'd consider it if I were you.
Yeah.
So, what do you say, pal? Help me do my job here and give me that change in your pocket.
You don't get benefits, though.
Says who? Hey, Fitz! Enough theatrics. It's your main man, George, and my partner, Purdy.
Hey, George. Hey, Purdy.
What on the streets? This ain't gonna last long.
Say what?
Cat food's gotta go from the porches, or the folks gonna get fined.
Why?
Too much of your kind coming around, freaking the folks out.
My kind?
Take it easy, man. It's not like you're eating skunk food. Reap the cat!
No fish about it, Stinks. We're taking a party over to the Blue Heron. Their dumpsters are divine.
The one over on Chester and what?
Yup, where the street light don't shine.
If this ain't gonna last, there are 2 porches over on Maine I gotta go visit. I'll see you in a little while.
This tea is delicious. Anyway, as you can imagine, I'm heartsick about Frank's passing.
You have a lot of nerve showing up here.
I'd like to see him one last time.
Frank is dead. You can't see him anymore.
He loved me as much as he loved you. He picked you 1 million years ago. I was his more recent choice.
You aren't the only one. And you can forget about seeing him.
I can't pay my respects. I understand you burnt him up.
It's called cremation.
And you have them here, his ashes.
My husband's cremains are mine, to do with as I wish.
What? To display on your nightstand? To stick on your mantle like some kind of sick trophy?
No. For certain visitors, I brew them into tea.
Facebook friends.
There's a difference?
Not to me.
You rate a commitment with only 1 star?
Is that bad?
No.
Good. Same as me.
No commitment.
No commitment.
Texting is not okay?
Before and after, okay. During, not so much.
And is that an important text?
From another guy?
No, from work.
Oh, that's okay then.
I'm okay if you're okay.
I'm okay.
Okay. Okay.
Update your relationship status.
I don't accept breakups by text.
No, that's how it is. We're done.
Say it to my face. In the meantime, I'm posting pictures of our Maui trip.
I didn't go to Maui with you.
I'm photoshopping you in. Smile. Speedo. Lay.
Fishes!
Engaged.
Ah!
Say it to my face, baby. So close, I can smell your blood.
Oh!
I know it seems small.
9 by 7.
That's really all the space you need.
For a bed, maybe an armoire.
Think of it as eco-friendly.
And I know there aren't any
window, which is technically illegal.
Oh, there's a skylight, so...
And the apartment doesn't have much common
space. Yeah, so you'll have to eat your meals in here.
But we got rid of our rat problem, so it's like...
That's a joke!
Look, we really like you. We want you to be our fourth roommate.
You know the housing market is tough.
You saw 25 places, you said?
You're not going to find a better deal than this.
Only $900 a month for a place like this.
I will take it.
Oh. Welcome to West Oakland!
Oh, I had the strangest dream about you last night. In the dream, I was trying to convince you to quit your job and go back to singing. I know you have never sung before in your life, but in the dream, it was a going back thing. That is weird, right? You kept saying that we were through and that you wanted to move on. Move on? To what? I have no idea. I mean, let's face it. It's not like you've got a whole lot going on right now, huh? You kept trying to walk away, like you didn't want to talk. That's hard to imagine, isn't it? What do you think it means? I mean, I'm not usually into that sort of thing. I know you are and everything, but I don't know. What do you...
I'm sorry. Have we met before?
Steve said, knowing that you're going to die.
Mike said, it's like a kind of magic, Ira.
Ira said, you'd like to be Mike. Ruin said nothing. The 14-year-old girl sat at her workstation for 16 hours a day every day.
Steve said, it's the only way I know to avoid the trap of thinking you have something to lose.
Mike said, did I see all those things? No, forgive me, but it doesn't mean that they aren't true.
Ira said, you'd like to my listeners to ever read one. Gruen said nothing. She placed a single button on the new iPad by hand over and over and over for months until...
Steve said, because you're already naked.
Mike said, I like to say I'm sorry, but I'm not.
Ira said, we even have to fact check David Sedaris now. Ruth said no. She stepped up on the roof. She climbed over the nets hung to the sides of the factory to prevent the suicides. And she looked up at the stars over Shenzhen and stepped out onto nothing. For a brief moment, the wind took her small body and she flew.
Yes, I tell stories for a living. The truth is ugly, but it is like a kind of magic.
Love flows out. Love flows in. Love flows out. Yes, very, very nice. Share if you're open to that.
It's like the whole world keeps moving. Rushing past like a swarm of hornets, and this happened. This happened! And life just goes on. It feels so dense, like an asteroid bearing down, but I look around and people just text and eat and fart, and no one, nothing is connected, and everyone is alone and blind and obtuse.
I'm obtuse?
Well, you mean well, you're just full of nonsense.
Oh, aren't you the little drama queen?
What?
Try again. Deep. Love flows in. Love flows out. In.
Get faster.
Sharon! Did you order a pizza?
How can you work like that?
I'm good.
But no, doesn't it feel weird lying down like that?
Seriously, I'm good.
There's a proper position to work in, okay? For like productivity, health, posture.
Comfy?
Actually. Yes, totally.
That's the word! Ergonomics! Scott?
How can you work like that? Doesn't it feel weird? And how did that make you feel?
Well, it made me feel like Chloe wasn't respecting my work. She was just so condescending.
Will you try something for me? Imagine her as a little girl, 4, 5 maybe, and then imagine that a woman sees her, a woman in her early 40s, not quite past biological ability, but certainly beyond, you know, active belief in her own childbearing livelihood. And she sees this little girl, this Chloe child, and she thinks she could have been mine. I had lived a different life, and of course she doesn't know the Chloe child, the meanness and the tantrums and the unnerving stare, and I'm ignoring you, Mommy, I'm pretending you're not here, and so she sees instead a symbol of the life she'll never have, and so it is, of course, perfection. Now, Regina, say what you were going to say. Say what you would like to say, but not to the Chloe you know. Say it instead to the emblematic Chloe child. Go ahead.
Chloe, when you said that to me, it made me feel...
Wait! I'm pretending you're not here!
Okay! How do you feel now?
One over there.
Well, I guess I'm going old school.
Sometimes it gets so quiet you can hear your own breath and it just gets you. It's not like you're enjoying it or anything, not like on a beach or a mountaintop. It's like that moment between 3 and 4 a.m. where something from a dream jolts you awake. And you open your eyes and you feel like there's a ghost or a presence or...
Could you, like, try to keep it down?
And then you realize where you really are. Between the cold sheets. And she's not there. And the room feels so cavernous. And you feel so lost and empty, you know? Like you're in a big city, and you don't know a single soul. And you close your eyes, and the emptiness balloons inside of you. And before you know it, the sky is a periwinkle, and it's 6 a.m., and there's no use going back to sleep. Do you know what I mean? Does anybody know what I mean?
I do. Yeah, I totally do.
Okay, so Joe.
Yeah.
This means you're you're gonna have to stay up overnight and supervise the software update, right?
I stay?
Is that okay?
Why? It's always me!
Joe, I got
you! I want you to help! Please, God! Pudding! Now, pudding! Damn you!
Okay, I guess Joe has Lady Gaga tickets and pudding related. Chris, can you stay over and
was, would you kill yourself for love?
I'm not 16 and in love with a boy in tights. I'm not romantic or in search of the moon. I don't believe that mulberry trees can uproot from human blood spilled in unspeakable grief.
You have no need or great desire to leave behind a legend.
No, I don't.
Why are you in the theater then?
To speak to people in the language of flowers.
Like Ophelia, the girl who drowned herself. Speak to me of roses and rosemary. Speak to me of pansies, fennel, columbine, and rue. Of bees, petals, pollen, thorns, of daisies.
Flores para los muertos?
Call me but love and I'll be new baptized. Henceforth, I never will be Romeo.
I want an Antony and Cleopatra kind of love.
I want a Clark Kent and Lois Lane kind of love.
I want a Bonnie and Clyde kind of love. You like that one?
I want a Sunday kind of love.
I want a Fred and Wilma Flintstone kind of love.
I want a Jim and Pam Halpert kind of love.
I want a Harry and Sally kind of love.
I want a John and Yoko kind of love.
I want a John and Jackie O kind of love.
And I want a Bill and Hillary kind of love.
Really?
Maybe not.
I know what I want. I want a Barack and Michelle kind of love.
I want...
You sure you want to go through with this?
Did my first tour, did my second, did my third, didn't complain. Won't make it through a fourth show.
I realized it this morning in the shower. The buzzing that was spiraling out of my gut was waiting. I couldn't tell or didn't know or wasn't sure what for. Not about you. Sorry, you're here. For now. Waiting for something I didn't have any reason to expect. This is it, Shell, right now. So I turned off the shower.
Here they come.
Yeah?
Dust trails on the road. They come visit me when they lock me up. You'll visit.
Yo, I'm the boyfriend inside on the couch.
Yo, I'm the girlfriend outside in the hall.
Yo, I'm the door. Keep you apart till you give me the key.
Gonna get home, order some delivery, sit on the couch, watch Netflix.
Key?
Where's my...
Yo.
if she just wants to chill out tonight. Maybe watch some Netflix.
Key.
I gotta go to the dentist. It's been, like, way too long.
Key.
Too many of my friends have been getting married lately. It's freaky.
Key. I can never find my key. I've got to get my shit together.
It's not that I don't want us to get married. It's just, it makes me feel old.
Key!
Oh, I hope I don't have any cavities. I don't want the hygienist to lecture me.
I feel like we never have sex anymore. I'm actually really worried about it.
Oh, Dub! Here! Key!
Ah, metal, 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 feed me the metal! Ah, key! No, to the right, to the right! Jiggle it a little! Oh, Tumblr!
I gotta get my shit together!
Tumblr! Tumblr! Kick!
I'm just not in the mood, I guess.
Yo, I the door am finally open.
Hey.
Well, what's keeping you apart now?
He shuffled toward the door, but Athelney Jones got in front of him. "Wait a bit, my friend," said he. "You have important information and you must not walk off. We shall keep you whether you like it or not until our friend returns." The old man made a little run towards the door, but as Athelney Jones put his broad back up against it, he recognized the uselessness of resistance. "Pretty sort of treatment, this," he cried, stamping his stick. "I come here to see a gentleman, and you two, who I never saw in my life, seize me and treat me in this fashion." "You will be none the worse," I said. "We shall recompense you for the loss of your time. Sit over here on the sofa, and you will not have long to wait." He came across, sullenly enough, and seated himself with his face resting on his hands. "Are you still awake?"
You are not going to die. I'm the fiancé and you're the soldier. You'll come back to me.
I'm sorry. Sorry, I just keep wondering, what's he going to look like? What's he doing today? What's he eating tomorrow? How's he going to approach me in 10, 20, 97 days from now when he's behind that gun and I'm on the other side?
No, no, that's not going to happen. You tell that shooter that you love me and he won't be able to shoot you. Do you hear me? He's human too. You smile and tell him how much you love me.
What if it makes him jealous? What if he pulls the trigger in spite of himself?
Then you pray. You pray, baby, and I bet that because you're blessed, he'll miss.
What if he shoots again and hits me in the heart?
Then maybe you'd die, but you'd come back to me, to life, because you love me.
What if I'm blinded and I can't see and I can't find you?
Then I find you, and I kiss your eyes.
What if I still couldn't see?
Then... okay, you couldn't see, but I'd still be kissing your eyes.
Can we talk?
Sure.
I want to ask you something. This is the problem with the queer movement.
Oh, I mean, gay movement. Let's be honest, there is no queer movement. Military and marriage, that's the agenda? Yay, I get to kill, conform, and castrate myself, too. I'm sorry, did you want to ask me something?
Never mind.
Oh, come on, don't be like that. What did you want to ask me?
Will you marry me?
Do
You can put that black 10 over that red jack. Oh, and look, if you move that 3 right there, you can uncover that car right
there's
there.
There's a reason they call it solitaire.
That's silly. Aren't we supposed to be, you know, helpmates? Isn't that what our marriage vow says?
Solitaire.
Don't you love me anymore? Married 3 months and already you just want to be left alone with your cards. Harry, I am talking to you! Harry? Aw, Harry. Harry?
I've decided to stop asking about it so you can stop lying about it.
Thank you.
Chekhov. She's brought an idea we really find very exciting, even with money so tight.
A one-woman, three sisters?
Cherry Orchard. I know someone will do your play. Could you excuse us? We have a meeting.
It was 10 years ago today I first went in search of my second most perfect self.
What a coincidence. It was 15 years ago today I went looking for my second most perfect self, too.
That's so strange. I first went looking for my second most perfect self in college, in all the most popular classes, but I couldn't find her there.
You've got to be kidding me. I also went looking in college, too, and I also signed up for all the most popular classes, but I couldn't find her there either. What school did you go to?
Cal?
Me, too. And after that, I went looking for my second most perfect self all across Europe, but I couldn't find her there either.
That's so strange. I, too, followed that very same rumor, and I couldn't find her there either. So I went searching for her all throughout the corporate world. But everywhere I looked, I couldn't find her.
Oh my God, that's exactly what happened to me. And now, following another rumor, I came here to this very spot, to this very moment, because I heard my second most perfect self would be here. And I brought this gun, because I'm going to shoot her in the head. So I won't always be so depressed about never finding my second most perfect self.
That's such a strange coincidence. I too came here to this very spot because I'm going to shoot my second most perfect self in the head too. I wonder when she'll come.
Yeah, I wonder.
You have two wishes left.
Where did you come from?
The bottle.
The bottle? Oh, is this one of those three wishes things?
Two left.
What happened to number three?
Used it.
Really?
You wish to forget.
Forget what? Did I have a painful life?
What would you know of pain?
That's my point.
I'm a spirit of fire. I'm terror given form. Before Suleiman sealed away our kind, we scorched the air as we passed, rending the sky apart with our inexhaustible malevolence.
Okay, I get it.
But just as velvet night smothers the brightest day, and masks the sun's gleaming radiance in a cloak of inescapable shadow, so too were my brothers and I broken, chained, our power ground to dust.
Okay, I just wish you would just shut up about it.
Granted.
Daddy, do you think the wings will work?
Of course I do. We built the model together, didn't we? Didn't the model work, silly?
Yeah.
Come here. We'll construct these wings and we'll fly out of this labyrinth, and I'll show you a whole world you've yet to see. Just trust Papa, okay?
Okay, Papa. Hey, look what I can do. You can't do that, Papa.
No, I can't. But I can do this. Oh, I see such a bright and wonderful future for you. I look up at the stars and I think even they are within your grasp. I want the heavens for you, my beautiful boy. Come on now, Icarus. Let's get back to work.
What do you want to do?
Seriously, everyone, just put it in your head what you want to do. Like, when you fantasize about the future, what does it actually look like? Are you doing it? I mean, the thing, are you doing it? Are you on your way? The only non-negotiable is being happy, and if someone hasn't told you yet, you are on time and fucking good enough and ready! So what are you gonna do? Die!
The expanding universe explained.
About time!
There was a big bang. Space-time is curved and expanding in four dimensions. But
sure.
There is no center.
Yeah.
Now, it's difficult to visualize this in four dimensions, but if we drop down a dimension and think of it in three,
okay,
and think of a balloon.
That's the universe.
Now, the two-dimensional expanding surface of the balloon is the universe. The dots, galaxies, receding from each other in every direction as it expands.
Totally.
Now, we perceive it in three dimensions. We know that there is a center to the balloon,
But here's the important part. Not to the surface of it.
But that's the center right there.
The term center is meaningless. It's like saying we're standing on the center of the surface of the earth.
Right on.
Now, keep that image in mind. But now jump up a dimension and substitute the balloon for the universe. That is why there's no center to the universe. Dark energy causes it to expand into infinity. You see?
Yes, I get it!
No, I don't! Honestly, I'm the center of my own universe.
What's her problem?
Young Republican.
I see.
You might not feel me, no matter how hard I holler. My pen, you're gonna hear it. I'm gonna dig in into you cry. My pen will make you weep. And this time, you'll be the one who moans. You won't be able to help yourself. Your body will go my way. Your ears will stick to my keening song. Your fingers will grasp my words. And your arms will wrap around my space. You will sigh. And you will listen. And your heart will say, tell me more. 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 Tell me. Tell me. Tell me. I miss the sound of your voice. Your voice. Your voice.
And didn't bother to answer. Act 4, I fell asleep. Act 5, I dreamed I was being produced on Broadway. I heard the applause and it made me feel important. Then I woke up. Act 6, I jumped in a cab. I arrived at rehearsal and I was late. Again. Act 7, I hid in the wings. The director was talking about me. Act 7.5, I emerged from the wings. Act 8, I said, this is my play. Act 9, I handed each actor a blank page. Act 10, I said, the end. Epilogue. The director said, but this emperor isn't wearing any clothes. I gave him the finger. He ran to the bathroom. The producer smiled, and I took my bow. The real epilogue. First hour of rehearsal. I told all the actors, sit in imaginary boats and row backwards and look at each other like you don't know what you're doing.
Tick, tick, tick.
You know how they say time slows down?
Tick.
Dilating like light and matter stretching toward a black hole.
Tick.
Dilating like your pupils as the ground rushes up.
Tick.
Dilating like your mouth at the sight of your brand new uninsured laptop.
Tick.
Your laptop falling like light and matter toward the black hole of the 49 municipal bus line.
Tick.
Well, it's all crap!
Oh.
No, 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 it's all good. I need to talk to Paul.
Welcome back at any time. Is everything that you can find out? Yeah, no, she's awesome. So, I'm happy to share because, you know, you're a commodity.
I'm sure it's a
Yes, they are. They too.
You, we'll pick him up after. You have
no, I gave him my program. Instead of my suit, I would like my program back before I come
to me.
I'm sorry. Mom?
Yes, sweetie?
Do you think I could get $20 for the mall? Oh my God!
Sonia!
What are you doing here?
I live here, John, remember?
Oh yes, of course. What are you doing here now?
I got laid off.
Sorry?
Yeah, I bet you are.
No, really, you loved that job.
Not half as much as I loved you.
Loved? Past tense? Listen, Sonia, he means nothing to me. I was just curious. Besides, he's a lousy kisser. He slobbers. Sonia, please.
Oh, all right.
Over the cliff.
My hero, it's your legacy.
I had to make a deal.
Tell me about it later. You have to hear this. The Keystone Pipeline?
The who what?
The 2,000-mile tunnel they want to run from Canada to Florida so they can suck out oil they want to squeeze out of sand. The one that is bound to leak and pollute the entire Midwest aquifer and put out more greenhouse gas than drilling.
Oh, that.
Listen. To pump tar sands oil, it must be melted by underground steam jets that require vast amounts of increasingly scarce water. Now here comes the great part. Most climate scientists suggest that this year's disastrous drought in the Midwest will soon be the new normal.
Excuse me, what's great?
There's not enough water. Put that out from your bully pulpit and you can kill the pipeline. You won't have to approve it.
Guess what deal I had to make. Oh.
I'm here for the 5 o'clock meeting with Mr. Fredrickson.
Okay, great. Just have a seat.
Your 5 o'clock is here.
Okay.
He'll be with you in just 1 minute.
Thanks.
Is it okay? Can I ask you, what's he like?
Oh, well, there's no reason to be nervous. He's really very friendly. Just don't contradict him. He hates that.
Okay.
But also, when he asks you a question, he usually has the answer he's looking for already in his head. So it's important to answer correctly every time. Also, if he begins berating you to the point where you start to seriously question your own sense of self-worth, and you start to think, can it possibly be worth this job for me to feel this way? I mean, did he threaten me physically? Did he lock the door behind me when I came in? Will anybody hear me if I cry for help? That is the moment when it's really important to remember to just be yourself. Okay, he's ready to see you now.
You're adorable.
What?
When you know I know something, you're so adorable.
Shut up.
It's true.
It's not. You always think you know something, and I think that's funny, so I make this face like this, and you think it is what it isn't.
Okay.
Seriously.
Really?
Yes, oh my God.
I don't believe
you. Oh my God.
I don't. You're a terrible liar. You've always been a terrible liar.
That's not true.
It is.
It isn't. If I was a terrible liar, how could I have gotten away with all the terrible shit I've done behind your back all these years?
You haven't gotten away with anything.
Exactly.
You haven't. Hey.
Hmm?
Bree.
What? Oh my God, I'm kidding.
Jesus.
You're so gullible.
I'm not.
You're not.
I love you.
I love you too.
Yeah.
was amazing. Really amazing. You are so good at that.
Thanks. So?
So?
Well, I need you to pay me now. Kind of how this works.
How this works? What are you... Oh, I didn't... No, really, I didn't know.
You didn't know? Bullshit.
I didn't. I'm not that kind of... I mean, I would have had the money to pay you if I knew that... I didn't know and I don't. I'm kind of, you know, broke.
Oh, shit! You know, normally I ask for payment up front, but you seem so, I don't know, nice, like a gentleman or a puppy or a gentleman puppy.
Is your, you know, pimp or whatever going to beat me up?
Independent. But if I did, I would definitely have him beat you up.
I'm sorry. Are you going to go?
Do you have cab fare?
Don't you?
Do I look like I have cab fare? We drove here. You know, I have bills. I have a kid. I needed this appointment tonight. I was counting on... You seemed so nice.
I get paid on Monday? Idiots who populate the local mall.
It's always the wrong kind of
the ones who are pushy
and loud,
bickering,
interrupting.
No appreciation of culture.
We were at the Treaty Fountain and these
Oh god, the Treaty Foundation is a nightmare. Completely overrated.
I honestly don't know how the Romans can stand it.
No wonder they hate us.
Us?
Well, not us.
And stop bleeding.
If you lean back, it'll clot in the bad way.
Bad way?
Yeah, the way that makes you suffocate.
If I'm talking, that means the passageway to my mouth is open, not going to suffocate.
Yeah, well, maybe some of the blood goes from the nose into the mouth and...
Can you think of anyone who's ever died of a nosebleed?
Attila the Hun.
Wait, really? Attila the Hun died of a nosebleed?
Uh-huh.
A lot of people die of nosebleeds?
I don't know. Maybe a few of those Russian czars.
Czars?
Yeah, the ones over the hemophiliacs.
I'm not a hemophiliac.
I know.
Was Attila the Hun a hemophiliac?
I don't think so, no.
But you're not sure.
Well, I think it'd be kind of hard to be a warlord if you're a hemophiliac.
Good point.
Do you deserve it?
Yeah. Yeah, I did.
You're in line to get clubs. You haven't played mini golf in a long time.
You haven't played mini golf in a long time. Last time you were here, you were with... That's right.
Last time you were here, you were with...
The twins.
Your old girlfriend.
They played mini golf.
You've been pissy that night.
Their father
because you would run into your ex at that restaurant.
They played on
your
ex and
stared at you with this weird expression.
They never miss a shot.
And afterwards, your girlfriend had been like, why was she looking at us like that? And you had been like,
shit. You realize this is the place with that fucking windmill.
Because I cheated on you with her?
The blades go around super fast. Last time you got stuck there. Couldn't get the ball through. Fuck.
You're such a fucking cheater.
Fuck! The twins are assholes. I wish...
You understood women better?
You don't know me.
I know you, but I wish I understood men better.
What am I?
That seems like a question you're gonna
myself.
Have to...
Myself. I wish you'd let
finish
me...
a sentence, why don't you?
So this guy you're saying...
I don't
he...
get him! He doesn't talk, but my brother loves him. They're like BFFs.
A-E-A-E.
And ever. But my brother is so... And then this guy is so... And they rap. They rap together. My big, loud, black brother and this tiny, little
white.
Guy. They're like the Penn and Teller of hip-hop.
Penn and Teller? They both dance and tap and stuff?
You're thinking of the Nicholas Brothers?
Never. I'm thinking Fred and Ginger.
Aren't we always?
Huh? What? Penn and Teller?
Are they dudes in Vegas?
With the big white tigers?
No, not those two. A terrible thing. What happened with the tiger?
What, in the zoo?
No, in Vegas. Focus up! Penn and Teller. They're the big one and the small one, and one doesn't speak, but
I think that's
James
out of the ball.
I don't think so. I'm
such
a hard time being. Go ahead.
You.
What?
Huh?
No kind of heat for a man.
I like it. It opens up your pores.
It turns a man's vital energies into some kind of mayonnaise-like fluid that seeps out of your pores. It makes your shirt stink like a dead man.
I see extremes of temperature as a little gift from God. Un regalito de Dios, as they say in Spanish. A way of calibrating our appreciation for the more modern...
I say it turns a man to a wet milkshake.
I see a glossy, vital patina of sweat on my wrists, and I think it is good to be alive.
I'm a man, goddammit, not a mushroom.
A day like this is a way to free a person from all preoccupation, from all illusion that he was put on this earth for a purpose.
It rots you, brain first.
Fine. You can have a drink of my beer.
Thank you.
She says she knew back then that there was such a thing as homosexuals. She worked in retail.
Sixth floor, please.
Going up. They had elevator operators in the store back then, and they had this little joke. Second floor, men's furnishings.
Afternoon, fifth floor, please.
Going up.
Fifth floor, advertising.
I'm meeting. I have, there's a meeting.
Third floor, shoes.
I liked what you said in the staff meeting.
Fourth floor, formal wear.
Mighty well spoken yourself.
Fifth floor, fairyland.
Say, do you have plans for lunch?
Some of the girls... No. No, I don't.
Great, I'll swing back.
Sixth floor, administration. You must have known, Mom.
All I knew was that your father was the sweetest, gentlest man I'd ever met, by far.
But he lied to you for years!
Honey, that's what we did back then.
I've never made it to a fifth date before.
Neither have I.
There's a dead bee on your dashboard. Goodbye, B.
Bye.
So he made me lie down on their bed. That was a big deal, to be on their bed. And he... And then he... I didn't cry.
No, you wouldn't.
Bit my tongue, gulped bitter blood. Then he stopped, lay down on the bed next to me, said, "Here, now you do it to me." Yes.
No.
Yes. I want you to know what it feels like to hurt the one you love. Do it to the bone.
He was beautiful.
You are breathtaking.
I liked his nose.
You are.
And his eyes.
So amazing.
And then he liked me.
I
wanted everything.
Fuck you so bad.
Everything.
Would you let me?
Not just his body, but him, all of it.
I fuck you.
And I said, yes.
Do you have any condoms?
And I said, no.
Negative.
And I said, doesn't matter.
I bet you.
I told him.
Doesn't matter. Not really.
And it hadn't occurred to me before then. We're so far away from that meaning, what it meant. And it doesn't matter. Not really.
Doesn't matter, not really.
But whatever, and don't you assume you know, whatever I answered him, it did matter. Really.
Sisters don't make brothers get out of cars.
Yeah, well, this sister does get out of the fucking car.
I'm scared.
Well, you should have thought of that.
It was an accident.
Oh, the hell it was, you destructive little shit. Get out of the fucking car.
It's dark. I don't know where we are. Look at that guy over there. He looks like a murderer. What if we're in a neighborhood of murderers?
There's no such thing as a neighborhood of murderers.
What if I can't find my way back? You promised Mom and Dad you'd look after me.
Oh, don't bring those assholes into this.
Can you just leave me in a neighborhood of dog walkers or stroller pushers?
Listen to yourself. Do you have any idea what it's like living with you?
I'll be a better person.
You can't. That's the point. You fucking can't. Get back in the fucking car!
Bro, what's up?
Oh, big moisture mud!
Woo! Sit! Ha! Yeah!
Hey, bro!
Bro!
Off the bus by himself today.
Today, you're telling me? How long does this
This is his first. Be nice to her. At last. But serious.
Seriously? We're too young to be grandparents. I mean, I'm glad.
I'm glad. They had you under forever. But you came through the procedure so well.
Well, if we'd started saving years ago. But we'll find a way to pay for...
For better or worse. Right? That's what I said.
I said, who are you? What are you doing in my room?
I'm your wife, sweetheart. It's your wife. Good morning. It's your wife.
My wife. Her whole life knew me better than anyone. I don't know where the time went. You're good to go. Did you take your pain pills?
Going home.
That's right. Please stand. You can rest. Finally, once we get you home.
Rest. Yes.
I do not have a problem.
She says you do. She's snapping a rubber tree in half. Does that mean anything to you?
Yeah, fraud.
Oh, she's showing me something. Who had the botched circumcision?
I want my money back. There's nobody here.
She's saying breach. Something about a breach. Oh, and she's going like this. Do you know anybody who's had a breached birth?
Christ, woman, you've been dead for 13 months. Will you ever let up?
19 hours without drugs. That's why they call it labor.
Let it go, Mom. So what is it? What's my big problem?
Call Judith?
I haven't seen her since she remarried.
Oh, she says you did 3 months ago. Oh, and she's throwing water balloons and they're exploding. Accident, schmaccident, come to Bubby. Call
Judith. What happens when we die?
Well, we go to heaven. And we get to see all of our family that's already there waiting for us.
What do you think happens when we die?
Do you mean, do we have a soul?
Yeah, I guess. Well, no, I mean, energy doesn't just disappear. The universe is a closed system. Molecules change form. You burn a leaf, it becomes ash and heat. Molecules don't disappear, they change form. So it's our molecules that's the one part of us that's truly immortal.
So if some part of us is immortal, then what happens to us when we die?
That's what I asked. So what do you think?
I don't know.
What do you think happens when we die?
No more pain. No more worry. You can rest now.
I swear he's getting worse. Did you notice?
It's all I can do to keep from leaping up there.
Maybe he's just tired.
Are you crazy? Did you hear him trail off at the end?
I was cringing.
I made new flashcards.
You don't get it. I think it could be...
No, listen.
Dom, we're looking at frontal lobe dementia or... Alzheimer's. That's what I'm thinking. Jesus.
I don't agree. I made new flashcards.
Flashcards are not the answer.
Look, I'll drill him every day. Gorbachev.
evil empire, welfare queen, there you go again.
Nancy can stand at his side and whisper.
We certainly can't tell anyone. I'll get you.
Talk to me, Gary. Seriously? No, that's great.
I speak 7 languages. Yeah,
call me back with the numbers. I'll pick up.
Did you know that?
Were you saying something?
I think it's a kind of immortality in itself.
Yeah, call you back. I have to go. Now.
You're leaving me. Here?
It's a nursing home. You're in need of nursing.
In a shoddy room without a proper window. If your father were alive.
He's not. You outlived him. Congratulations.
Does this assuage your guilt?
I'm incapable of guilt. Hello?
Thank you. You're welcome. You were taking too long.
Out soon enough, kiddo.
Don't open your eyes, Billy. It's a surprise.
Mom, what did Santa bring? Let me see.
Easy now, buddy. Be patient.
No peeking, sweetheart, or Christmas will hurt you.
Yeah.